Okay, hello everyone and welcome to round number 7 in our June 1v1 tournament. This time we are going to be featuring Popsursocks and Gameslayer. Popsursocks coming off a win, Gameslayer coming off a loss. We'll have to see, he'll be looking to make up for that in this round. Food and silicon starting expensive, and what on earth is this map? There's just water everywhere. And then they forgot to put anything else down. There's carbon, we could work with a scavenger here, potentially, that could be okay. I am concerned about this aluminum situation. I think you'll be looking at like scavenger. Yep, right about there. No big surprise for that for Gameslayer. We are also going to have a scientist this round, which could be interesting. He's got... I mean, the water's pretty nearby. I'm a little concerned about the adjacency and the lack of a triangle on the steel is always just a little frustrating. But it could still work out. Popsursocks also managed to get the high aluminum. Gameslayer is going to be stuck on the medium. Underground nukes available this game. Oh, this could be weird. We'll just have to see what happens. What's going to happen this game? Like the underground nukes as a scavenger, that's not something you're going to want to see. Especially when you have to take both medium aluminums. The black market, like, what do you do? Popsursocks immediately used the black market to pick up a claim on water. That's interesting. So he didn't push to the upgrade quickly. He's just getting that water claim done. This is going to slow down his upgrade pretty significantly. It also, if Gameslayer's paying attention, he'll see that black market purchase go down, and he'll realize he doesn't necessarily have to be super concerned about extra black market anytime soon. First of all, because Popsursocks will be on cooldown. Second of all, he won't be able to afford it super easily, very, very fast. Because he'll have to upgrade, then he has to get down his buildings for his upgrade. And so Gameslayer should be a little more secure against that for the moment. May not rush to anything defensive himself super, super fast. All right. Not a whole lot more to talk about at the moment. We can see Popsursocks has done this interesting little thing of linking up his farm immediately, wants to make sure that he's not being hit by pirates. But this does leave two tiles in a bit of an awkward position because I don't see anything great for him to do with them. Solar panels may be his best bet, but silicon's already expensive, of course. And all the silicon is over on this side of the map, so he can't actually pick any of that up anytime soon. So we can't afford to put down panels anytime soon. On top of that, power's just not all that expensive at this point. He's only running on 2 steel mills, so he's not driving that power price up. We are going to see instead glass kilns, but I don't think this is going to work out too well either, for the same reason the solar panels wouldn't. Silicon's already expensive. There's no pressure on the glass except for the players themselves, from the, like, nothing from the neutral colony. Kims would be potentially okay. Electrolysis would be potentially okay, but you can see this glass kiln is actually just losing money at the moment. And that's not good at all. He actually cancels the other glass kiln. This is what I was concerned about. Like, you can maybe commit these claims to make sure you get the food, but look at all that that Popsursocks just wasted. He built a glass kiln, which cost silicon and steel, and then it lost him a bunch of money, and then he scrapped it, right? Not where you want to be. Not where you want to be at all. Gameslayer, meanwhile, has ended up with rather interesting territory due to wanting to rush to those farms instead of the water pumps, try and get in that food money while he could. Ended up transitioning around. He'll have to transition back because he claimed the good water initially. Then he built farms on top of it, and now he's kind of going to want to push those into water pumps. So it's just, it'll be a little awkward situation for Gameslayer too moving forward. You can see both these players not entirely sure how to approach this map either. High water auction is interesting. I mean, there's plenty of water on the map, but it is, of course, an extra claim. And I'm not too surprised to see it get taken for 8,000. Fuel cost on that is going to be a little frustrating for Popsursocks potentially, but still... could be okay. I am just a little concerned about how far away it is, though. That is going to be rather expensive water tile, all things considered. Alright, water pump's doing a good job for both players. Popsursocks now has, you know, some decent farms down at least, which are going to be okay. He's also pushed into reactors, so as he keeps this water price down, this is, I think, the only play that was available to him. Go ahead and just put life support down on not water and collect the water yourself. A little bit awkward since the whole reason he was making this play in the first place was to get access to those water tiles so that he would be able to put buildings directly on them. But hey, you do the best with what you have, right? Maybe just not completely thought out from Popsursocks, but maybe in the late game, it'll actually all pan out in his favor. Gameslayer seems to be struggling mightily at this point, by the way. He can't seem to get anything together. I think part of this is because he went ahead and committed to this silicon tile, which, yeah, it's worth something, and it does give him access to the glass, but his water is sitting around doing nothing. He's got to be concerned about power. He's getting into a geotherm now. That steel shortage is not something Gameslayer is going to be happy to see. And this farm is also not doing a whole lot. I expect glass kilns to be coming up in a moment. That's what we do, in fact, see. Once he gets these online, Gameslayer should be able to pretty effectively push through to 4. But meanwhile, Popsursocks is just sitting back on life support like, eh, whatever, I can buy the glass, not a big deal. And he's going to be totally okay, I think, moving forward with what he has. The question is, where does Popsursocks go from here, right? He's got the life support established. He could rearrange it a little bit, making it a little bit better. But that's not really going to bring in too much more money. And he also has to worry about power. So HQ4 is going to be really important for Popsursocks here. Gameslayer does get to it first on the back of those glass kilns. That's going to be just fine for him. Going to be able to move into reactors pretty easily. That's not going to be a problem. Chem refinery is also a possibility. So Gameslayer has a pretty clear path forward. Popsursocks, on the other hand, he's got to be worried about this power situation. He's going to have to do probably more about it than this single geotherm, which is definitely going to be a bit of a concern. And then what does he do to actually make money? Chems are a possibility, but without access to that carbon, it's definitely a little more awkward. He's already got the reactors down on top of that. He can't really do glass easily for the same reason. Feels like he needs access to just one more primary resource this game in either silicon or carbon in order to find a good path to move forward. Looks like we've got just a little bit of a fight over this cliff here for the wind turbines. Popsursocks making a good claim initially. He takes the middle spot. These are all very strong, so he takes the middle spot. As we talked about earlier, you take the spot that has the best chance at adjacency. So Gameslayer, he doesn't even want this cliff anymore because he can't get adjacency on either of these two tiles, where Popsursocks is pretty much guaranteed that possibility in the future. I'm a little concerned about the fact that Gameslayer has stuck on this one geotherm. He has the extra claim. He's gotten into a solar panel now. Would have liked to see maybe just a little extra power. No more geotherms available on the map. Did make that difficult, though, so I can kind of understand his situation. Popsursocks, I can't agree with this pleasure dome at all. I mean, look at how much power it's leaking for him. He could be running a surplus on power, but instead he's in a deficit. Not what you're going to be looking for at all out of a pleasure dome. And I mean, it's a 1v1 pleasure dome. They're never going to be great. There's no expansive players down. It's just really an awkward thing to have down altogether. Second wind turbine from Popsursocks is going to be nice to see. Gameslayer is going to want an extra claim, I feel like, so he can actually get a decent amount of power out of these solar panels. Popsursocks does have a spy down, getting ready, it looks like, to go ahead and take this away from Gameslayer. Solar flare going on, not all that important, as it will disappear in just a moment. Let's see, Gameslayer, no mutinies bought up at all. Does have an upgrade available to him if you would like. It feels like it's been a fairly passive game out of him so far. Pirates dropping from Popsursocks. Popsursocks being the one to really do some work with the black market this game, it would seem. Also still has that mutiny stored up, possibly wanting to target that at a geotherm or defend against a geotherm. Just not quite committing it anywhere for the time being. Extra claim auction. This would be a little bit awkward. There, finally the mutiny lands on the solar panel as expected. A little bit late, though. Power's already dropped off because, of course, it has been day for quite some time. Don't know at all where this auction is going to land. kind of an interesting situation. Gameslayer has the debt, but he might be tempted to give it to Popsursocks to try and keep him in debt. And that's exactly what we see. There are, of course, claims available on the black market. Gameslayer has good access to that. They're still pretty cheap. So not the end of the world to let a claim go for 18k if you think you can push your opponent deep into debt with it. My big concern is there's nothing like a circuit overload this game. Gameslayer would have to function entirely on the back of mutinies. And in fact, he did attempt one on a geotherm, but it got intercepted, and so that's not what he's going to be looking for. Very bad situation for Gameslayer now when it comes to the power. He's going to have to hope that this interest tick is strong enough to knock Popsursocks down into D, so Gameslayer can kind of find his edge this game. Because if Popsursocks can keep from spiraling out, he's looking to be in a better and better position as this game continues. He does still need to hit HQ level 5, of course, but as a scientist, he's just so well defended against those tools like power surges and underground nukes and all these other things that are available to him that Gameslayer isn't going to be able to use particularly well. Excuse me. Popsursocks does hit HQ 5, which is going to allow him... Well, it's got extra claims. He can start looking at those off-world markets. The Pleasure Dome's going to be a little bit more powerful. He's going to have extra space for this patent lab now. I don't really like that it's been running for quite that long period of time. You know that I don't really like the patent lab in 1v1 in general, but it's not a bad thing to pick up. It also potentially could give him access to... I mean, he doesn't really need to get access to carbon. He can pick up carbon scrubbing with this patent lab. I do like that he's managing to use all these steel tiles effectively. Of course, the slant drilling really only gave him one extra. The other thing that it does is allows him to subsist on pretty much just this one water patch. Slant drilling is definitely going to be a strong, strong tool this game. You just always have to wonder if the patent lab itself ended up being worth it. This game is going to go long enough that I think it's quite possible, especially because we did have a patch not too long ago that brought down the prices of patents in our 1v1 games. So teleportation only 40 instead of 80, superconductor 20 instead of 40. Just makes that building significantly more viable in the 1v1 setting. Gameslayer, meanwhile, has gone for an optimization center, which makes me wonder, yeah, offworlds really aren't all that strong yet, which is why you might see the optimization center just try and subsist solely on those on-world prices. Popsursocks does have carbon taken up. Using that slant drilling to get a high carbon tile. It's interesting. It's interesting to commit that whole claim there. But just the one claim? Since you already do have the patent lab, Gameslayer are going to try and take that patent lab away and pick up thinking machines. I think I like that decision, especially against the mutinies, against the power surges. That's going to be pretty darn important. Popsursocks, kind of disappointed that he didn't go ahead and goon that. He actually has the goon squad already. So he should be attempting to take that back as soon as possible just to keep Gameslayer from getting thinking machines. In about 2 seconds, he'll have access, should be able to just mutiny, goon immediately, and be in a pretty strong position. Patent Lab does get taken back. Is he going to goon it, though? That's the interesting question. He chooses not to. I think that's just a straight-up mistake, honestly. He could have committed the goon. He had the goon there. He could have committed it to completely securing that patent lab. Instead, he's chosen not to. And I think that guarantees thinking machines for Gameslayer. That's a really big mistake out of Popsursocks. All that said, Popsursocks, I talked about how the late game was going to go well for Popsursocks. And man, look at how much potential cash plus resources he has right now. I think a lot of that has been committed to this off-world market now, so that's absolutely fantastic for him. Gameslayer is still nowhere near the off-world. He's running on this optimization center, trying to make that work. He's trying to, he has to get this water, got this awkward glass kiln here. Meanwhile, steel is just pricey as can be, and Popsursocks still looking to be in a pretty great position. Gameslayer, he's just not doing anything over here. No real money to make, and now the nukes have started to land. Where did that one go? Right onto... I imagine this was a medium water tile. Maybe it was a low. If it wasn't a low, that's a bit of a mistake. Or if it was a low, that's a bit of a mistake. I think it was a low. Probably should have hit this high here. Maybe expecting a water pump. No, he's got the spy down. I think that's actually just... If that's a low, that's inexcusable. If it's a medium, it's fine. Offworld Market is online for Popsursocks. Gameslayer hasn't necessarily spotted this. He should have seen the steel mill get turned into a steel mill, so he might know about it. But mutinies are already so expensive, I think he's just going to be in a lot of trouble here. And Gameslayer still just completely stuck. Unable to get a whole lot done. Trying, it looks like. I can't even say what it is he's trying to accomplish at this point. All these on-world prices are so low now. This optimization center, once again, I feel like just a straight-up mistake. Look at this. Water, nothing. Carbon, nothing. Even though the on-world wasn't good... Or sorry, even though the off-world wasn't good, on-world is typically going to fall off pretty rapidly once you have a high-level scientist in the game, because they're just so good at shoving down those secondary resource prices, that food, the oxygen, the fuel, the steel. They can just keep making those for as long as they want to, because of course they're a scientist and pull their resources straight out of the ground. So I really don't like the optimization center decisions there. The Popsursocks also has one, it looks like. I don't really know what the point of that is. I don't even, in fact, know where. Is it in here somewhere? Does it just look like one? Where is it? Is it off this direction? Here it is. It's way down here. Maybe that came up in an auction when I wasn't paying attention. I typically ignore auctions these days because they get the job done. But you can always interpret the game state later on, so eh. Doesn't really matter what came up in an auction and what didn't. But yeah, Gameslayer, he's trying to function on just electronics, but of course, Popsursocks with the off-world. Gameslayer's got his own off-world now. And that's good to see that he actually has that tool available, but Popsursocks, more of his own stock, more of Gameslayer's stock, two off-worlds at this point. Coming online, two off-worlds because he mutinied away Gameslayer's, excuse me. Gameslayer, even with that thinking machines, doesn't look like it's going to be enough to keep him in this one. He does not have the cash on hand to save his own life. Popsursocks could sell down most of what he, pretty much everything he has, and kill Gameslayer on the spot. Of course, he doesn't really need to be concerned about that because he's operating on the double off-world to no off-world with these mutinies. And he's going to keep himself in a strong position no matter what else happens this game. I think this one is just about wrapped up. Popsursocks never collapsing completely into a debt spiral despite his high amount of debt. He's managed to keep enough of his assets available that hasn't been an issue. Gameslayer still can't quite defend himself, it looks like. Doesn't have the money on hand. Popsursocks, I'm kind of hoping, finishes this up after these launches. Look at all this steel that he has on hand. He can just sell this down very quickly, finish off Gameslayer. Not going to be a problem. He got rid of the steel by building an off-world market. That's completely unnecessary. He could have killed Gameslayer. He could probably still just about kill Gameslayer. Whatever. It's fine. New land is available. It's not fine. When your opponent can die, just go kill him. Just go kill him. Just be like, I'm buying you. You're gonna die now. Because it turns out, no matter what decision you make, if you could have made a different decision that resulted in immediately winning the game, you made the wrong decision. Congratulations. There's just no two ways about that, right? Our methods continue to improve. My categories, he's joined us. He's going to express his opinion about this whole not killing your opponent when they're dead situation. Of course, mostly the reason that I don't like it as an observer is because, well, the game's over, right? The black market is, I don't see a route for Gameslayer to come back into it. Maybe it does still exist. Here's the thing. Whenever you don't kill your opponent and could have killed your opponent, not only have you not won the game on the spot, which is just bad, you've given them a potential to maybe come back. Maybe they see something that you didn't. Maybe you'll make a mistake. There's no reason to open up that possibility of mistakes for yourself and open up that possibility of winning to your opponent, right? There's no need for that. Don't do that. Just end it. Offworld shipment launched. Get it done. Look at all the money. That's all right. That's all right. I don't even know what to talk about. Popsursocks is buying into his own stock instead of just saving money to kill Gameslayer. Gameslayer's trying to fight back. Both players are in D levels of debt now, so there's something. About equal, in fact, so interest ticks could be fun. Still no financial instruments. Arguably, the single most powerful patent in 1v1. I'm just throwing it out there. Financial instruments, like, that's right next to thinking machines. It just gives you so much cash in these games with massive amounts of debt. And so it kind of bothers me to see it passed over so often. It's okay though, because we have perpetual motion for that $2 power price. Alright. Well, Popsursocks still has a crazy amount of money. Gameslayer still doesn't. Gameslayer managed to build another offworld, which had the nice effect of giving Popsursocks another offworld so he can try and clean up this game a little bit faster. So I do appreciate that out of Gameslayer. That kind of thing is always nice to see. Thing is, we can actually point out a mistake here. I think, well, does Popsursocks currently have this? I don't think so. I can't really see the border very well. Gameslayer currently has two, so Gameslayer has his and this one right now, I think. Yeah, Gameslayer has this one. So what happened was, Gameslayer took the off-world market of Popsursocks, because Popsursocks shouldn't have thrown down this mutiny here. When your opponent has thinking machines and you have an exposed offworld, typically it's better to just buy mutinies and then sit on them, because you make your opponent get aggressive first and then you cancel their mutiny, which in effect gives you an extra 120 seconds of offworld time for your mutiny, despite the fact that your opponent had thinking machines. What Popsursocks did was attack Gameslayer. Oh no, this isn't even thinking machines. Gameslayer, don't you have thinking machines? Come on, I'm expecting better out of these players right now. So thinking machines doesn't actually do anything for Gameslayer on this tile, so it all doesn't matter, and Popsursocks made the right decision. Because Gameslayer decided that it was more valuable to have this high water pump than to have his offworld protected from mutinies. I don't know. Anyway. Or even over here. Like, that could have gone down over here. Turn this into like a patent lab and pick up financial instruments because you like winning the game. I don't know. Look, you gotta build your offworlds adjacent to your headquarters. So Gameslayer only has four tiles adjacent to his headquarters right now. But when you pick up thinking machines, at least use it. And all of this is a completely moot point because the game has been over for the last like 3 days in game. And Popsursocks, once again, has the money to end it. It's just all wrapped up in water right now.
Offworld shipment launched. Look at all the money.
We got there.